While the memories of my recent Fayotech G4 teardown are still fresh, I want to go ahead and attempt making my own 3-axis gimbal. So I started gathering the ingredients. Brushless gimbal motors, basecam gimbal controller, cables, screws, and some special parts that have to be created first. As a handle, I'll use, believe it or not, a handle. The rest will be aluminum at some point, acrylic for a first prototype. Let's not talk about how much time I spent on this little decoration, but it's approximately what I have in mind. I learned a lot about SolidWorks making it, but I didn't find a way to determine the center of gravity of an assembly, so I had to do it the traditional way, hypnosis. Balancing a gimbal is very important, because in an imbalanced system, the motors are always working and draining your batteries. To balance a gimbal, you turn the center of gravity of every axis into its pivot by aligning it with the motor's axis of rotation. That's why I have to go through all this effort to find the center of gravity of the camera. This is it. Now, one more time without the lens cap. I'll draw the acrylic plates in LibreCAD and CNC machine them, which is a pain in the ass always. You get the idea. But the outcome is usually better than expected. I'll heat it up along that prepared bend line and bend it as squarely as possible. The exact same thing happens for the longer plate too. I also made a base plate out of FR4 PCB material, but that went totally smooth and uneventful, so no reason to mention it here. This problem was so small that I was inclined not to mention it at all, but its remedy produced a cool shot, so I'll include it anyway. Alright, first assembly. Enumeration giving away the success of the same. Yeah, don't worry, it isn't dead yet, it's still twitching. The long plate is too flexible, obviously. When a motor moves, the plate flexes, which the motor has to compensate again. That causes oscillation. So I'll make some reinforcements. I'll double up the long plate and glue in these triangles with UV curable glue.
Loathsome flickering lamp, you've plagued me long enough. You're on my list now.
All right, another assembly. That's looking a lot better already, but the occasional shake still happens because of a slight imbalance in the yaw axis, and I didn't do any PID tuning yet. But that's a boring process, not worth filming at all. Something that is very much worth filming is going to happen in Hanover this weekend. It's the annual Hanover Maker Faire, and I'm going to be there with my ridiculous gimbal trying to shoot a little video. On Saturday, probably. See you there, maybe.